The end, if you could give me a crystal ball, Paul, what do you think's going to happen?
I think we're gonna lose a Power 5 conference. I think that's what's going to happen. And I think right now that the bullseye is right on the Pac-12 because it was built and centered around Los Angeles, which they've completely lost and aren't getting back. There's no way to get Los Angeles back. So because of that, I don't see a way that the Pac-12 moves forward and that the TV partners are really enthusiastic, even though they still have some pretty big TV markets in that deal and some pretty big brand names. The biggest one left, and it took the other school in that city with it, and USC and UCLA are gone. So I see some sort of merger. I mean, if we thought last year with two teams leaving the Big 12 and then four other teams coming in was chaotic, this is going to be truly chaotic because I think a lot of things are on the table. And if I'm the Pac-12, I'm really nervous about the future. And if I'm the second most nervous, I'm the ACC because you're locked into a TV deal from now until the end of time, it probably feels like, comparatively to all these other conferences that have negotiating windows that are open soon, which means that they can make moves easier than you can. Doesn't mean that they can't, but it's going to be hard for them to do it, or harder.
Yeah, I've got like a million things on my mind. I mean, for one, when it comes to the ACC, what is what really with that grant of rights? Because yeah. I'm seeing people act today like that. Oh, it's a cool $100 million. They can do that, no problem. Make that money back in the new SEC in like 2 years. It's like, I think you realize how much money that really is. And I think you realize you just cut that $100 million check and wait a little while for it to come back to you. It's not really that simple. Now, the contract itself might be. So for the legalese, for the lawyers out there, please tell me how the ACC can get around this contract outside of just the obvious, which is, you know, some sort of mass exodus that would null and void it, or, you know, somehow or another the money is there to be had. Although, again, we're talking hundreds of millions of dollars for multiple schools is what we're looking at with the ACC scenario. Because I know the prevailing thought is that Clemson and Florida State and Miami and any combination of Georgia Tech and like a couple of others, that's what everybody's got in mind, right? That they're going to now be the next wave and they're going to splinter off into the ACC or into the SEC and the Big Ten. I mean, that's entirely possible, and I would expect that, yeah, that's absolutely what's going to happen. But a lot of people just seem to act like that's going to happen soon, and I would just love to know whether that is something to be expecting, whether that contract, that grant of rights is something that they can get out of that easily, or is this a scenario where legitimately that thing is ironclad for another 10 plus years?
Well, if you're Wake Forest or a school like that, that could, and NC State, Georgia Tech could very well get left behind, even though it's in Atlanta, because it's not a big school in Atlanta, it's a school in Atlanta, you know?
But there's a lot of thought about them.
Yeah, I mean, so, but also, like, you're going to hold out just like the Big 12 would have with Texas and Oklahoma until the bitter end, until you know how much money you're going to get because you're screwed. And you were. So the other thing that people may not realize is, yeah, a bunch of these schools have money, but you know, Florida State, Miami, they're not just throwing money around. I mean, like, facility upgrades at those places have taken forever. They probably would need this deal to go through to really get what they wanted done. UNC's got a bunch of money and a bunch of academic prestige, but, you know, not everybody's the same way. You know, Notre Dame's a wild card out there. There's so many things that have to happen with the ACC. It's not, like you said, Craig, it's not simple of just like, ah, it's $100 million. It's not. I mean, it's not that simple.
Yeah, it's not impossible. I think it was Louisville's AD that said that. And, yeah, if you're every school in the ACC right now, I do think you're looking for your life raft and your preserver, just like the Big 12 was whenever Oklahoma and Texas made their announcement. I think it's the same thing. It's just, you know, a year later and a little bit more of an uncertain sort of future, where now any rumors and talk that's been going around for years at this point about a Power 2 is actually coming to fruition. It's actually legitimately happening and will begin for all intents and purposes in a couple of years, if not sooner. I mean, all I know, and I've got a million questions, because we could go just simply with the Big 12 storylines. We could go simply with the Pac-12 storylines. We could go simply with the ACC. Each conference has like a dozen storylines going on right now, much less the bigger picture. But, you know, it does seem that they are, you know, trimming the fat, and we are going into this two super conference system, and what that means for the rest of, you know, the folks out there is, yeah, some getting left behind, some getting left out, and what that ultimately means, you know, in the not so much near future, but in 5, 10, 15, 20 years from now, I mean, who the heck really knows? I mean,